Hello, and welcome to Screen Printing 101. Today's topic, screen reclaiming. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Jim Steven, and I've been working in screen printing for the last 33 years. I know a lot of you have your way of cleaning screens, and by all means, you probably have the best way to do it. I've been training people how to reclaim screens for the last 6 years, and currently a lot of the companies that I've been working with are still doing it the same way. Most companies that sell chemistry, perhaps it's Image Technology or ICC, ISS, McDermott Autotype, Easyway Products, there's several out there. But if you do it consistently the same way, each time, your frames will come out very clean and to a 60% ratio of not having to use a haze remover, as we know, can be dangerous on older meshes or even newer meshes when it comes to certain colors. So as you see, I'm using a technique I like to call the Karate Kid technique. And what I'm doing is I always start on the inside of the screen, the squeegee side, like you should. And then I'm applying the screen wash to the print side of the screen with a side-by-side motion and an up and down motion, which I like to say it's painting the house and painting the fence. Each screen gets about the same amount of screen wash on them, but consistently they're being brush down the same way each screen. And if I do see anything that has an area on the frame with ink on it, I'll go with that brush and go over the frame itself to make sure that it will go ahead and clean the area so that I have less work to do when it comes to cleaning the screen. Screen wash is 60% water, 40% chemistry. After you start using it on the screen and to go down the drain with the water that you have to wash off of it, it gets down to be about 90% water and 10% to 5% chemistry, so it's not doing anything bad to the environment. California has their rules. A lot of states have their rules when it comes to the chemistry that you're using, so you might want to check with the city or the area with the AQMD to find out which products are safe for you. This product here is an Easyway product. Again, I'm using Easyway because that's what the company has provided for me, but if it were for me, I think I can use any kind of chemistry to make sure that it's gonna work on any screen that I do. Most of the mesh counts I'm using in this company are 305, 355, 380, 420, and a 460 mesh count. We do a lot of high graphic, and we do a lot of work for the auto industry, for car inserts, for new car license plates. Also, we do a lot of work for the state and for the school board. But right now, currently, we're doing a lot of work for the animal restoration committees and having made dog collars, or I guess you could say dog cones for the veterinarians. But again, all the screens I'm doing right now, I am applying a screen wash to get rid of any of the ink that's been sitting in the screen for a matter of 8 hours. I try not to leave my screens any longer than 8 hours, but typically I do wash screens twice a day, once at 9 o'clock in the morning and once at 1 o'clock in the afternoon. And typically I can do about 30 screens an hour, but when it comes to a hard reclaim, I'm about 20 screens an hour. But with the way we're working right now, I can do about 25 screens completely on this size screen. Time to reclaim the screen. So again, you want your proper PPE products, gloves, mask. If you have glasses, you should be okay. Newer people, they tend to use a full-on mask and the coverall suit and rubber boots and gloves that go up to your elbows. But if everything is done the proper way, you don't need all that equipment. Right now, the company has provided me with a spray system, which I don't care for very much, but since they have it, I'm using it here. And each one is color coordinated. So with this one, the yellow sprayer is being used by the yellow brush, which I'm applying the stencil remover on here again. And as you can tell, I'm doing the paint the house method. Now I'm doing the paint the fence method. And now I'm doing wax on, wax off. This will consistently apply the stencil remover all over the print side of the screen. I'm sorry, the squeegee side of the screen. And since I already sprayed the back with the stencil remover, I'm going to apply with the brush again, paint the house left to right, paint the fence up and down, and wax on, wax off. Well, that time I didn't do it, but typically I would, but you can tell that the stencil remover is already coming off, taking off the emulsion. Now with a high pressure washer, this one is a 1800 PSI washer. All I'm doing is I'm taking off the emulsion. I'm not worried about the ink that's on there, anything right now. I just want to take off the emulsion and get rid of it. Because that's what the stencil remover is all about, is to get rid of the emulsion. It's not made for anything else, not made for stains, it's not made for ink. But as you notice, I didn't do anything with the screen wash. I left it on there and I applied directly the stencil remover. As you can tell, I am spending some time in certain areas, and that is basically to get off the block out, the blue solution to take care of pinholes. But as you can see, it's taken off most of the ink that was on there from when I put the screen wash on there. So going by it really quick, getting off the stencil that was on there before. The tape, I don't care for that blue tape on the outside. That's not the way that blue tape is made. It's not for that process. It actually goes on the inside of the frame so you don't rip your screen when you're putting your mesh on to the machine, or the frame onto the machine. Now that's done. As you can see, now I have a red brush, and this will be actually used for the haze remover or the ghost remover. And that's what happens every once in a while. You pop a screen. Now this was an older frame, which I'm not really upset that this one popped, but it does happen quite a bit. And I've been going through my screens in the last 2 weeks, and I think over the last week itself, I replaced 15 screens with new mesh. It's very expensive to do that, but it's necessary because these frames have old mesh on them, and I replaced them. I put the blue tape on the inside. Now here we go again. I'm spraying the stencil remover on the squeegee side, and now I'm spraying it onto the print side of the frame, and then I'll go back to the same motions of the yellow brush to take out the stencil. So anyways, back to the frame itself. If you apply that blue tape to the frame, you will have less problems with any damage to any critical area of that frame itself, because when the press operator gets his screen, they're not as careful as I am when it comes to using the screen. So here I go with the wax on, wax off Karate Kid motions. And now I'll go and flip the screen around and go to this print side of the screen, which already has the stencil remover on it. And I'll go with a back and forth motion, which is I call paint the house. And then the up and down motion, which will be paint the fence. And now I'm doing wax on, wax off. So with this, of course, you can see that it's all coming off, all the stencil, and you could pretty much use a hose without any pressure to get that stencil off. But with the 1800 pound PSI spray gun I'm using, you're for sure going to get off any excess ink that the stencil, the screen wash was still on there, taken out. But also, you're taking off any residue from the outside of the frame, any stencil that might be there from before, any block out from a previous job that had a lot of pinholes in it. But you can see how fast and easy the stencil does come out. And again, a lot of you are saying, yeah, I know all this. But my concern is when you have a new person coming in to start in the department, typically the owners put a temp or somebody that has no idea what they're doing in this department. And to be honest with you, as a press operator knows or a screen printer knows, this is the most important department in screen printing. Now I'm applying the haze remover with the red brush again. Hopefully this one doesn't pop. Up and down motion. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that frame, go back into the inside or the squeegee side of the frame, and apply the haze remover or ghost remover on the inside of the frame. And again, I'm trying to cover every area possible, especially the sweet spot of the inside of the screen. And with that, I can let that set for anywhere from 10 to 15 minutes, and it won't do any harm to the mesh itself. There are some ghost removers that are very caustic and will cause problems and will have the screen pop at certain times. So again, one more time with the stencil remover on the squeegee side. I'll spray some on the print side of the screen. And again, with the brush, the same motions, always consistently. I'm going to go with the Karate Kid motions.
That's.
Show me pin defense.
Face. That's.
Show me side to side.
Yes. That's.
Show me sand or floor.
Hat! Face.
I know it might sound kind of funny by using the expression the Karate Kid motions, but a lot of us have seen the movies, if not these movies. We've seen the Karate Kid comedies or whatever they've done to make it kind of funny about the wax on, wax off thing. But it's a consistent way of doing things, and it makes sure that it's always being done the right way, the same way, and you're going to get these same results when you do it consistently. And it's about being consistent. It really matters about screen washing or reclaiming screens. Again, you can't stress to an owner of a company how important it is to have a clean screen. Without a clean screen, a job on press could be zero. And it just takes more time to run it twice and you lose the money. So you might as well do it right the first time and get a screen so clean that it can be used for a clear coat or other jobs. And we know that the hardest colors to get out of the screen are the blues, the reds, and the blacks. And if you're using a adhesion promoter with your ink, which a lot of people do, especially for polypropylenes and polyethylene materials and static clings, you're using a cure promoter, and this just makes it even worse on that mesh. I always kind of sample it to having a brand new t-shirt. When you have a brand new t-shirt, you spill coffee on it, the faster you get into that wash and you take it out, you're going to be able to get as much of that stain out of there But on an older shirt, if you spill coffee on it, that mesh or the material itself is going to hold that stain in there, and it's going to be a lot tougher to get out. So you have a period of time that you want to make sure that these screens are going to be 100% clean, so that when you get to it, the next time you coat a screen, it's going to be as clean as possible. So at this point, I'm still going to put a haze remover on all these screens, because these are older screens that have been used quite a few times. And again, this one, you can tell the blue tape is gone, because I took that blue tape off of there. I got sick of it. And later on in another tutorial, I'll show you how to stretch a screen using the blue tape. And with these are Diamond Chase screens for Sakurai presses, which is an automatic cylinder press. But these frames are very old. They don't even make these kind of frames anymore. And what I'll do is I'll try to find ways that I can show different kind of frames on how to make them. Everything from the Newman rollers to the hectagon bolt Diamond Chase screens to glue down frames, several different frames out there. But again, we're going through these and we're showing a quick way to take the stencil off and apply the haze remover onto the screen. And again, with the haze remover, we don't want to leave it on for too long, because first of all, you can't leave it on overnight, because it doesn't do the same effect as it would for 10 minutes. And also, it does damage the mesh. It will rip the screen. It's like putting bleach onto a black shirt. It will cause the colors to change and the screen or the mesh to rip. So one more time, we're applying the stencil remover to the screen with the yellow brush, consistently with the same brushes. You don't want to cross over different brushes and use different chemistry for different brushes. It's just not a good idea. And again, if you're using the same brushes for the same products all the time, it's consistency. And the person who is watching the screens should know this, that you're always being consistent. Consistent, consistent, consistent. You're just going to be happier that way. And when you're done with that screen, it's going to be so clean that you're not going to have a worry in the world when you're ready to put the emulsion on. So now we're at our last stage, which is removing the haze remover that was applied. I did about 14 screens in this session of video, and now we're going through to do the last part. Now this side here, of course, we know is the squeegee side, and this side here will be the print side. You never want to use that pressure water gun on the print side of the screen, or the squeegee side of the screen, because that water will shoot back at you in no time. And that's why a lot of these guys wear these big coveralls, because they think that water's going to hit them no matter what. Again, this is haze remover being applied and washed off with the 1800 PSI gun. And it's going to remove whatever was left on that screen. As you can tell, I'm 2 inches, 3 inches away from the mesh. It's not going to rip the mesh unless there is a hole in the screen. And as you're going through back and forth, you want to always start from the top. No matter what you're doing, you always start from the top and work your way down. The reason is because the water coming down is not going to stain any area. It's actually going to wash off to the bottom of the screen and go down the drain. Now, this part is done. I took off the haze remover. I'm turning off the power of the gun. And now I'm going to put a hose on there. And a little bit of water, not too much, because if you put too much water, it's going to spray on you, and you just don't need that. I'm applying the water to the inside of the frame so that anything that is there that is from solutions or haze remover or anything I'm using is going to be washed off. But now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a degreaser. Now, typically, degreasers are soap, but with these will be soaps that are consistent with not creating a lot of foam. But again, you're not going to use any kind of foams or any kind of sprays that are going to cause foaming, because you're just going to create a mess in your tank. So I'm spraying it on to the print side of the screen. And again, all it basically is soap. And with that, I have a different brush. I'm using a green brush for the degreaser. So I started with the blue brush, and the blue brush is going to be for the screen wash. The yellow brush is for the stencil remover. The red brush is going to be for the haze remover, and the green brush is going to be for the degreaser. I'm going all over there, because places I can get to with that degreaser. And then I will use the water hose, and I'll take off as much as I can, hit the frame, because the frame does have solutions on it, the inside of the screen, and this part right here, if you look at it when you actually wash the screen, they call it the waterfall effect. And it will show the water come down from the screen, from the mesh, and look like a flow of water. That means the screen is completely clean. Again, going inside, trying to get as much of the solutions out of the screen, out of the frame itself. That blue tape is just making me mad. So I'm taking them off all of my screens. And from now on, none of my screens will have that blue tape on that side of the screen. It just makes a mess. I'm draining all the water. I lift it up so I can drain from all the corners of that screen. And that screen was used several times with several different jobs. And it's pretty darn clean. It's ready to go for another job. Let me speed this up for you so you guys can see the finished results for some more screens. Here in this frame, you can see that the blue tape is already coming off, so I just removed it directly, and it gives me an area that I can clean even better now. Get rid of everything that's on that mesh, went over it again just to make sure that there was no residue from the tape left on there. Bring that hose back, take off that water, degreaser, and again, just being consistent about it, making sure that the frame, the screen, everything is washed off, rinsed off, so it's ready for use again. I want to thank everyone for your time and watching this video. I did spend a little time working on it, and it's kind of a new thing for me to present things like this. But I think that screen printing is an important thing. It's still around. It's still being used today in quite a bit of companies out there. And if you like the video, please click the like button, and please subscribe, and I'll be having videos coming out periodically, and with new information, and I'm deciding whether I should do a podcast or not, and invite some of my friends that have been printing for quite a while with their techniques, everything from inks to emulsions to chemistry that they'd like also, and the different presses that are out there. I will show screen stretching techniques, I will show coating techniques, and of course mixing ink, UV inks, LED against UV, and so on and so forth. So please subscribe, please like, and I hope to see you again soon.